Hello from Lyon in France. I'm back in front of the tunnel that I talk about in all of my videos. You're probably fed up of this tunnel, right? Okay, well let's take a look at a map of Lyon and see where else we can go. So I'm here at this X. You can see Lyon is very built up, like any city. But what's this big green bit at the edge of the city? Let's go there by bike and find out. The green bit is a park called Le Grand Parc de Miribel-Jonage, and it's over 2,000 hectares of nature. There's a nice cycle route to get there that's separated from cars pretty much the entire way. If you know someone who's reluctant to get on their bike, this route might be a nice thing to suggest to get them riding because it's stress-free, picturesque, and there's a nice destination at the end. The signs on the right here show that this cycle path is being worked on to make it part of the future high-speed cycle network. In the meantime, there's a bit at the end where the path turns into a strange blue carpet. On the right, you can see an entrance to another big park called Le Parc de la Tête d'Or. It's another nice place to visit. It has a big lake that you can hire boats on, a zoo, greenhouses, and many other things. Now we're on a lovely path that follows the Rhône. This is a voie verte, which means that it's shared with pedestrians and cyclists. It's quite wide though, so I don't think there's really any problems with conflicts between the different users. This path is also part of a long cycling route called the ViaRhôna. If you continue in this direction, you can follow the Rhône all the way to Geneva. In the other direction, it leads all the way to the Mediterranean Sea at the south of France. The big building on the right is the international headquarters of Interpol, the international police. Now I'm in a park called Le Parc de la Fessine. It's a nature reserve, like the one we're going to, but in comparison, it's tiny, at only 45 hectares. There's quite a few routes through here that run in parallel, so you can take your pick here. The yellow UFO-like thing on the right is one of a set of disused wells created in 1887. Apparently this used to be an important source of water for Lyon, but they're no longer used. You can see from the map that the cycle path has a corner here so it can follow the river. I think if you wanted to take a shortcut, you could turn right at the well and skip this out. But you might have to join the roads for a bit. I'm going to take the long way around. We'll be right back. this is one of the few bits where we have to cross the road. There's a slight climb too. We need to do this so that we can cross the bridge above. The bridge is next to the motorway, so it breaks the peaceful atmosphere for a bit. We're not actually crossing the river, but instead a canal called the Canal de Jonage. This was artificially created in 1894 in order to generate hydroelectric power at the dam further on. The dam's quite pretty and worth making a detour if you fancy it. I wonder if this burnt out car is meant as a warning sign that Lyon is now a cycling city and cars aren't welcome. Nah, I'm just kidding. On the right is a large flea market. I've never been to it, but my mum told me it was shown on British TV because people were buying antiques there and bringing them back to the UK. So I guess it must be an internationally recognised market. The bike parked on the path here is called a Velov. It's the cycle hire scheme in Lyon. Hiring a Velov could be a good way to try this route even if you don't have your own bike, because it's mostly flat. Apparently, there's a special solar-powered station near the beach in the park that can hold 100 Velovs. There's a long straight bit here, so it could be a good place to pick up some speed, but you have to watch out for some tree roots, which make a few surprise bumps in the tarmac. There's a building here that says Ferme de Morlaix. I always wonder if it's another farm like the one in my last video, but I can't find any information about it online, so maybe it isn't actually used anymore. As you can see from the bus on the right, it's possible to get to the park by public transport too. I haven't tried it for a while since I found out it's much nicer to go by bike. Last time I did it in the summer and the buses were packed. I think they've added more lines recently, so maybe it's nicer now. Thank you. Okay, we've arrived at the lake in the park now. The entrance here has several handy amenities like a cafe and these toilets on the left. I'm going to take advantage of them to fill up my water bottle. You can see the beach on the lake here. A lot of people come here to swim and have a barbecue. This part's free, but there's another part to the right that you have to pay to use. It has lifeguards and slides for the kids. I've never tried it myself, but paying for the lifeguards might be a good idea, because I hear stories of people drowning in this lake every summer, sadly. So now I've got a confession to make. My plan here was to show you one of the recommended routes around the lake from the park's website. I was going to try this route number 3, which goes around the lake. However, I ran into several problems. First of all, I didn't pay attention to this important word, VTT. It means the route was meant for a mountain bike. But my bike looks like this. It's a road bike with very thin wheels. When I tried riding on the mountain bike tracks, it looked like this. I end up riding at walking pace and sliding all over the place, so it wasn't much fun. The other problem I had is that there's soon going to be a music festival in the park, and part of the route is blocked off to make space to prepare the stages. The third problem is that my battery ran out on my camera, so in the end, I gave up and went home. However, there's some quite nice tarmac routes around the lake that are more suitable for my bike, and there's lots of things to see, so I'd still like to come back and do a part 2 of this video after planning a better route around the lake. So until then, thanks for watching. If you want to see part 2, don't forget to subscribe so you can get notified when it comes out. Bye!